Hello there. I'm Shelley Carney with New Mexico Day Trips.
You sound excited. And I'm Toby Yunus with New Mexico Day Trips.
We have just left the Walking Sands Rest area, and it's Saturday, the 1st of April. Funny thing, I got these emails today from different places that were like April Fool's jokes, and I was like, what? It was unexpected, but today is the 1st of April, and we are on our way to the open house at the Trinity Site, which is only open 2 days a year, and this is one of the days. Should be very nice weather for us this morning. We should get there about noon, and hopefully there won't be any kind of lines or anything. People should be, the bulk of the people who went to this should already be done visiting it and have moved on, so we'll be in the second wave, I guess.
Yeah.
Things are starting to green up. It's spring. The temperatures are supposed to be in the 60s.
We're at 56 even, right now, but by the time we get there, it'll be in the 60s.
Yeah, might even reach 70 today.
Mm-hmm.
After we see the Trinity Site and the McDonald Ranch, we are thinking about going to the rock shop in Bingham to see if they have any Trinitite. I don't know if they'll have any vendors selling Trinitite today at the field, but
the sense that I got was that the vendors that were going to be selling souvenirs were from White Sands. But I'm not sure. If they're selling Trinitite there, I'd probably get it there.
Yeah.
I do know the rock shop has some. I remember seeing it the last time we were there.
And, you know, if we see any dry arroyo washes below some mountains that we think might have minerals or gold in it, then we might scoop up a little dirt and take it home.
We did bring the bucket and the classifier, so.
Yeah. So that's what we're up to today.
So the 2 days that this location is open is the first Saturday in April, which happens to be the April 1st, and the second Saturday in October.
I think it's the third one now.
Is it the third one?
Because they have the Balloon Fiesta the first 2 weekends.
Oh, that's right.
So I think they didn't want to compete with that anymore, because it used to be the first Saturday, and I think, you know, it was too much competition with Balloon Fiesta, so they decided to do it on the third Saturday in October now.
Anyway, the point...
Oops,
I'm sorry. Oh, you're right. The point of this location is that this is where the first test atomic bomb was exploded back
in July.
The gadget, that's right. Back in July of 1945, the next month, August 8th, if I remember correctly, the first atomic bomb was dropped on... I'm going to go over to this side of the road because it's smoother. First drop, atomic bomb was dropped on Hiroshima, and 2 days later, the second bomb was dropped on...
Nagasaki.
And so the nuclear weapons age began. And this is part of the story that we want to continue from when we visited Los Alamos as well, and the nuclear museum in Albuquerque. These are all tied together because of this story. So we're looking, this is kind of the place we needed to visit, you know, just to kind of finish out this continuum of the nuclear age that we had started when we first visited
the
nuclear
museum. Also
the
Space Museum.
Oh, that's right, because the Space Museum.
There's a big caravan of 125 vehicles that will come over from Tularosa Basin, you know, and it's kind of put together at the Space Museum.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So, anyway, we're looking forward to it. There is not much to see there. There is a stone, it looked like basalt, actually, obelisk at the location where the bomb was exploded. There are very low levels of radiation remaining, nothing dangerous. And then there's the McDonald Ranch, which was taken over by the military and which was used to make the final assembly. That's it when it comes to this location, so I'm not sure it's actually going to make an entire show.
Yeah.
But we'll do our best.
Yeah. That's why we add the extra stuff. Trip to the rock shop, picking up dirt.
Yeah, yeah. We may have some other things that we have to do.
All right, we'll see you when we get there. We're not allowed to do any photography between the Stallion Gate and the parking lot. So we'll see you when we get to the parking lot again.
Yeah, that's the next time you'll see us.
So we are waiting in line to go through the Stallion Gate. It is just after noon. There were some protesters as we turned in to this road. What were they protesting?
They're the downwinders. The people that live downwind from this location are dying from various forms of radiation causing cancers. Mm. We got some pictures. So we were told that once we get onto the location, onto the road.
Past the gate.
Well, usually the gate back there is the one that's locked, the one that's off 380. So we assumed that was the gate. Apparently we're going to another gate up here. And we're 3 miles in, and I don't know actually where the gate is. We're moving a little bit at a time. But it's just a matter of waiting. We were told, as Shelley said, I think in our intro, no cameras, no photos until you actually get to the location. But there's nobody here.
I think it's between the gate and the parking lot.
Yeah, that's probably where they mean, you think?
Yeah, because, I mean, if you didn't watch the video, you wouldn't even know that part.
Right.
Unless somebody told you.
Well, that's what I thought, as they referred to the gate, I thought they were referring back there to 380. So, anyway, we're sitting in line patiently. We should be fine. Could be a little bit, but we're not going to make a big deal out of it. Okay.
So we're in line for the bus to go to the McDonald Ranch. And it took us an hour sitting in line with the cars to get in. So let me turn this around. And now we're in another line. So exciting day of lines. It's not like being at Disneyland.
Well, it does require some patience, but it only happens twice a year, so I'm glad we're here. And we've been able to get here without a lot of difficulty, and we decided to go take the bus out to the McDonald Ranch first, since they're going to be closing here in another 45 minutes at the gate, and so we'll get back from there, and then we'll go up to the obelisk at the Trinity Site. Okay? Thanks, guys. My pleasure. Nice meeting you.
And good luck.
I used to be able to say that in Russian. I think all I know is privyet and dasvidaniya now.
Yeah. Thank you.
Спасибо.
Пожалуйста. Have a good one.
All right, guys, here we're getting on the bus and just had a wonderful conversation with a gentleman and some of his family members that are originally from Russia. And I recognize the accent, so.
Hey, can you turn that down?
Two more. Just made it. Made it onto the bus with two seats to spare. Got a family coming back. And this is the bus that's going to take us to the McDonald Ranch, which was the ranch that the military, ranch house, which is the ranch that the military took over to, as part of their takeover of White Sands and a missile range during the development of the atomic bomb. And that's where the bomb experienced, that's where the folks that were building the bomb experienced the final assembly. So I'll turn us back on when we get there. We're at the McDonald Ranch following the group in, They have something over there as well. I don't know how long we're going to stay here. Maybe just long enough to catch the next bus, because we still have to get back to see the Trinity site. So, good. Beautiful New Mexico high desert. Right in the middle of the Rio Grande Rift. Those are mountains on the, let's see, east side, right? Those are east of the rift?
Yes.
And those were formed by volcanic?
Tectonic.
Tectonic.
Because we're on the east side of the Rio Grande.
Got it. But there's gold in them in our hills. It's on.
That's mine.
Where are we now? On this map.
I would say we are right in front of the house there. What do you think?
Well, yeah, because the sky is there. Looks like
2 miles.
Back to Trinity, yeah.
Not back to the south of this
bush. Oh, oh. So I think what we're going to have to do is just take this shot and call it a selfie shot.
Okay.
Okay, so we're probably not going to get a chance to take photos, so you'll see a lot of these because we're going to take selfies with the video camera. All right. This is us at the McDonald Ranch.
Click.
Excuse me. It's actually a DJI action, but concept is the same.
Here comes the wind.
Do you want to walk through?
Yep.
No, we're going to stack them up along the wall.
Too much light in here, so I don't know what you guys can see, but we'll do it anyway.
It's just an empty room at this point.
Something must have made it for all the stairs. case you ever needed a place to assemble your own plutonium, you could just come here.
Had a nice view, didn't they?
Yeah, it's beautiful. Before they took it away from him.
Well, then whoever took it away got a nice view too. Just a little ranch house. There's not a whole lot going on in here.
Let's make a left.
You just keep on coming.
Oh, this is an in and out. We'll just get a...
I'll let you go out there.
I'm going with you. Oh. Let's go back out that way.
All right.
I'll be right here if you guys want to go in.
Excuse me.
Well, I mean, it's, you'll see it pictures down there, and because you'll see the trucks coming, they come in before we have to.
Apparently, one of the old ranch buildings built of rock. Lord knows, there's plenty of rock around here. All right. We're going to head back for the bus so that we can get back in time to walk to the Trinity site, because it's about a, what did they say, a quarter mile away?
Guess so.
There is a pamphlet that comes along with a tour, but I think it's back at the Trinity location. And they said we're 2 miles from there as the crow flies.
It's so. Got a time capsule in it.
Pardon?
Time capsule. It sat on the other side. It says 1984 time capsule.
Yeah.
Then what's your...
New Mexico day trips.
New Mexico day trips?
Yeah. Do you have a business card?
Oh, if you got one, it'd be awesome.
Yeah. It's youtube.com/nmdaytrips or at sign.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you for asking. You know what? I need to... Let me just get some stills here real quick. Go ahead. I'm going to turn off the cameras and we're going to get some still shots. Here.
All right. So there you can see my eyes. I'm an honest person. We just got off the bus. We went down to the McDonald Ranch. We came back out. Now we're going to walk down to the Trinity site. And it's pretty much just... the most exciting day ever. I guess I could put my glasses back on.
I think she's being facetious now. All right, we'll get you started up once we get up to the Trinity site, okay? We just left the media tent. We had to check in and we got a media kit. And now we're headed. And passes. And now we're headed to the Trinity site. As usual, we're late for everything, so looks like everybody's coming back, but it's actually been good. We were smart to take the McDonald bus, because the last one's going to depart in about 10 minutes, so we got that taken care of first. They said it was about a quarter mile, looks like about that. So we'll check back in when we get there, guys. So we're coming up on the... We're coming up on the location. That's Shelley. Show me your media pass. So that's her media pass because we're media.
It says...
We're new age media.
Your media badge must be on your person and visible at all times. Do not harass visitors if they do not want to talk with you.
Does it really say that?
Yeah. If you want to interview a White Sands employee, please speak to PAO first.
Uh-huh.
Please turn in your media badge when you leave.
PAO is Public Affairs Office. Remember Max that I told you about?
Mm-hmm.
That was Max.
Oh, yeah. Samoyed.
Yeah, that's what it was.
I had friends that had a dog like that, so that's how I knew what it was.
So you can see the obelisk in the background. We'll get you closer to it. And there's an example of Fat Man back there as well. So we're to the cool stuff. Some kind of display table here. Oh, it's got a Geiger counter. Let's go see if we can get Shelly to buzz here. So there's some samples of Trinitite.
So imagine puddles of
Can I pick? May I pick that up?
Yeah, feel free. Yeah.
Over here. Everything on here.
So the blast.
So
oh, it's
we
off.
Actually have alpha, beta, and gamma on this table. So the reason you don't want to smoke.
No, not smoking, but just.
Yeah. Okay. Two things. One, tobacco leaves. When you're ingesting the tobacco leaves, you get a lot more radiation.
So that's the response from the Geiger counter Trinitite, which is the material that was found on the surface after the explosion.
Yes and no.
Let me see. Oh, yeah, you're radioactive.
So, no, if you're just smoking and walking around, you're probably
too close to the microwave.
I wouldn't put that down, and I wouldn't rub it on things because it's damaging. That's putting radiation everywhere.
Okay.
So we're not allowed to eat, drink, or smoke when we're in a radiation area.
No,
you're not in a radiation area here because of the...
You can't do it either when you're around pesticides.
No, you're not really.
So, lots of rattlesnake signs.
Probably not too many around close by today, all these people walking around talking.
So there are some signs. I'll make sure that we get photos of them. What?
I said free answers.
Oh, that's
can
cool.
Can we go ask them the meaning of life?
So they have some scientists over there. What's some answers? Okay.
Should we go get to the obelisk?
Yeah, we better get to the obelisk.
All right.
So I'm talking about radiation. I'll get your picture. I don't want to get in the way of this photographer here.
Well, yeah. You got a lens that long, you're lucky to get a shot. But it's not crowded with people.
There's a bunch of signs and pictures back there.
Mm-hmm.
So this is the infamous obelisk, Trinity Site, where the world's first nuclear device was exploded on July 16th, 1945. And it turns out that this young gentleman here actually survived it. So I'll get some pictures for you. We have to do a selfie. Let's walk this way. Like this. In the shot. There we go.
Yep. You want me to take one?
Pardon?
You want me to take one?
Would you please?
Yeah,
sure. Hold that for just a sec.
This is the time to come for photos right now.
Yeah, it? Nobody's here. Yeah, if you can get the full obelisk in, we would appreciate
it. Yeah, sure thing.
Ready?
Ready.
Oh, want to do this so I can see the sign?
Yes.
Yes.
There you go.
Thanks. Thank you. We appreciate
no
that
problem.
Very much. Hold up for a sec.
What's that?
I want to get a picture of the, what do you call it?
The what do you call it?
No, whatever this is called. What's
the rock.
It called? No, the sign.
Oh, the sign. The sign on the rock.
Oh, we can do the same for you.
Oh, I've actually got ones like that. I wanted a selfie too.
Oh, okay, all right. Got to get the selfie.
It's a different
yeah.
I believe you dropped the ball on that, man.
All right, let's go over and see Fat Man. So Fat Man is the bomb that was tested. And once it was tested, it was determined that it would be safe. Well, safe is the wrong word, probably, to drop on the city of Hiroshima. It was Little Boy, which was a different configuration, that was dropped on Nagasaki. So, if you were to scrape enough of the earth here, you might be able to find some Trinitite, but everywhere you look, they say.
All right, you stand in front of the bomb and do a news report, because you're media now. You got to do that.
Hey, everybody, this is Toby Unis with New Mexico Day Trips. We've made a trip out to Trinity Site today. You've gotten to see the McDonald Ranch, you've gotten to see the obelisk that represents the exact location where the first atomic bomb was exploded, and behind me here is an example of what is referred to as Fat Man, which is similar to the bomb that was set off at Trinity Site, the configuration set off at Trinity Site, and just a week or so later was dropped over the city of Hiroshima, Japan. One more dropping of a bomb, Little Boy, on Nagasaki, and the Japanese came to the peace table.
Very good. Now you are media. You're rocking the way. Keep trying to trip me. Bad rock.
I'm just going to look on the ground, see if there's any. So we're going to head over to the rock shop in, what's the name of that town?
Bingham.
Bingham.
Do you want to see what's along the wall or the fence?
Yeah, we should. All right, we're going to walk you over to this fence where they have all these pictures probably of the location and the event and maybe the scientists. But if you want to see them, if you want to see them, you're going to have to come out here yourself.
Yes. Okay.
There's another interesting building over there.
A little bunker, dealy.
Well, it's too close to be a bunker. You wouldn't want to be this close, no matter how much bunked you were.
Maybe it's a sample bunker, and they just put it here because that way you don't have to go anywhere else to look at what it would look like.
Oh. So they preserved this after the explosion so that people could visit and take a look at the Trinitite that had been left behind, and it was visible through this opening, but eventually the sand covered the Trinitite, so it is no longer visible. That's what I mean. If you were probably to dig 6 or 8 inches underneath any of this, you'd find yourself some Trinitite. But if you don't get here, you can actually look it up on eBay, and you can buy samples of Trinitite on eBay. And you've heard me tell the story before, but my Uncle Albert, who worked for 20 years at Los Alamos National Laboratories, had several samples of trinitite. All right, we're going to turn you off now. We're going to go look at the pictures.
The other 80% didn't, because it blew itself to smithereens. It
fizzled.
So the other part, the 80%, is all locked up into the trinitite. Gotcha. And the fallout and everything else.
Gotcha. I have a question.
Shoot.
There's a concrete extrusion over there by the obelisk.
Yeah, you're welcome.
And it's got a rebar fence around it. Yep. Is there any significance behind it?
That's one of the footings to the 100-foot steel tower on which the bomb was placed for the test.
All right, thank you. Mm-hmm. I was curious about it. It didn't have a sign, so.
Yeah, we ought to talk to them about that.
Did you want to look at their photos?
Oh.
So, questions?
More trinitite over there.
This the size of the actual one, or is this the size of...
So the one that was in there was about this size, right?
Okay.
About the size of a softball.
And then most of it blew.
And so most of it been... So what? The part that went nuclear to make the 20 kilotons of energy, 40 million pounds...
There's our tower footing that we just talked about.
This much by volume. Of course, it was all melted and, you know, went everywhere. Wow. But this just gives you an impression.
So there's Jumbo after the
this
test.
This is what they wanted to go nuclear.
This is when
this
they
is
blew off the
percentage.
Top.
And about
the bottom,
20%
of 1946.
Went. And this
that's
is equivalent
the top
to 40
piece
million pounds.
Out in the desert.
So, what was the purpose of
big
Jumbo?
Explosion.
The idea was that since this was so uncertain, this test, getting the 32 lenses of high explosives to go off at the same instant,
mm-hmm.
they thought that they could do the test in Jumbo, and if it fizzled, they didn't get that perfect implosion. Jumbo would contain the 5,000 pounds of high explosives and contain the plutonium inside Jumbo, and they could recover it afterwards.
So
they decided against that because it really would screw up measurements and stuff.
So they used the 5,000 pounds of explosives to
that's
create
what,
the
that's
compression.
In the bomb,
right.
And it's a ball around a ball. And 5,000 pounds of it.
And the difference between Fat Man and Little Boy was that Little Boy was made more like a gun?
Yes, it's an artillery tube, basically, and they shoot one piece of uranium into another piece. They squash together and get that critical mass to get a nuclear explosion.
Is there a short answer for what's the difference between a fission explosion and a fusion explosion?
Mm-hmm. Bigger bang.
Yeah, that is the short answer. That's the shortest answer I've ever heard.
A bigger bang.
Sorry, so they didn't actually use Fat Man in the end because it would screw up measurements? Is that what you said?
No, the bomb that was tested here
thank you
was the internal Fat Man bomb, the internal part of it. That casing is what they use. Is there to protect the bomb while they're flying over to...
Okay, the one it's behind me. So you got to move over this way.
What are we doing? Selfie?
Outro.
Doing outro. Oh. All right. Well, that was Trinity Site, and it's April 1st, 2023. It's a beautiful day here. We lucked out on the weather. And, that was pretty much it. We're going to head back now and maybe hit the rock shop.
We're going to hit the rock shop for sure.
Okay.
Because we can buy some trinitite there.
Yeah.
Hopefully.
So as Toby said earlier, and you probably didn't see it because we were not filming, we have gone to the Nuclear Museum. We've gone to the Bradbury Science Museum in Los Alamos. So we've seen a lot, and this kind of put the cap on the pen, I guess.
Yeah.
There's
going to be another word for that.
The last thing we needed to check off the list of our...
Nuclear history of New Mexico.
Atom bomb.
Yeah.
1945.
All right, guys. Thanks for watching.